Checking the traps, beaver traps.
Nope, got nothing in with me. Except a little crawfish in with me. Coyote's been down here, look.
Last day of trapping season. Set these last night, and nothing came through. We had a lot of rain the last several days, and water in these creeks were really high coming across fields, and so it gave the beaver a lot of options as far as their path.
This was that rut that I was telling you about where I stepped right off with this.
A little deep.
It got up to, because the water was all the way up to here. So.
Little mud in the face.
Yeah. I'd rather do that than lose a finger.
Trapped two beaver out of this creek a few weeks ago.
This is where those wood ducks come up out of last night too. There's
and with the
this area right here.
Spring rains and the thaw, it has flooded out the creek. Not sure if we got all the beaver out or if there are more here. They just moved around the traps or not, but trap sets were good until the water rose up.
I've got one right here, so if you stand here, I gotta go in down there to get to it, sir.
I bet that was deep the other day then, huh?
Yeah, I didn't set that one down there until yesterday. There's like three old bait bins up in here. You can see one right here.
Yeah.
In there. But the creek has dropped another probably a foot since yesterday. Right here before that. There's a drop off right there. That's what the stick's for. There's another bait bin right there. And nothing in this one. These are nice because they have those safety latches on them.
Uh-huh.
And actually they make an additional safety you can put on here.
Oh.
Typically, well, see where those roots are
sticking
out? That was all dirt before the flood. In the same way over there, that was all that washed out the last 2 weeks. Typically they had a good run right there and right in the middle that we could have set four traps on. The creek's still up a little bit. I'm gonna try and climb up this bank. Save you a few steps.
Yeah, let me get this on video just in case.
Just so you can see me fall in here and drown.
Tell your kids this is where it happened.
Alright. All the rest of them. Oh, I got one live right here in the trap. He's right here. See him?
Oh, yeah.
The little one. So my drowning rod didn't work, obviously.
You want to shoot him with a 22 or a pistol?
I got a pistol. Got a small one. This was a caster mount set. Here's her caster. And actually I had two traps down there. I'm surprised he didn't get in the second one. So, he's off a little, but get down there.
Is that a foothold?
Yeah, that's a foothold trap.
There's your shot.
But the water's just not deep enough to...
Missed.
I'm trying to hit him right in the head.
Well, I got mine, but... Did that get him in the head?
I think so. Kind of looks like it. The way he's acting.
Nose down?
Yeah. Alright, I'm going to check this other one across the way while he finished eyes. Oh
yeah,
see this is all first. They've done this last night, and that wasn't good.
Yep.
That's from them. That's their caster where they pull that up.
So you had two traps.
I was going
each through. One had its own drowning rod. Uh-huh. And he got caught in both of them and kind of kept him from going down the drowning rods.
Correct. They worked against each other is what they wound up doing. It was designed to have one should have slid off and drowned and then maybe get the second
So you need to set them a little further apart.
Yeah. Well,
yep.
I got a front and a back foot catch, so.
You dropped your little wire behind you, but.
Lesson learned on that. This is where I was thinking we might just float that little thing. I've got another set right up here. Actually, my other two sets are right here.
Okay.
So what I might do, John, is just
leave that stuff here and
float that to us. I can check them on my way back out and get that. As you can see, the creek's dropped again and exposed my trap.
Yeah.
Because that was about this deep yesterday.
Water cold?
A little chilly. And then I've got one more right over here. You can't see it, but there's been something come up and disturb the mud on here. You can see their footprints in it.
Yeah.
Obviously, I don't have one in this one, or else I'd already be on it. Because my drowning stake is right here. That other trap right behind
you. Yeah. It's not tripped yet.
I've got the latches, the safety latches are on. So.
End of season, clean them up.
Yeah, might as well get the mud off of them now, white fresh. I think it would hurt to go to the next size up on this rebar because it bends so easy once you set it.
Yeah? You mean a heavier gauge?
Yeah, a heavier gauge because it's hard to get it pushed in sometimes because this place here.
Oh, yeah.
That's the other bad thing is you hit rock right there. So you don't get much of a
sand and rock. Definitely a good idea floating a tub down here.
And I didn't put that hole in his tail. I didn't miss that. Okay. I'm just looking for more sign to see if there's any other beaver.
Be some good eating tonight, folks. Mm-hmm. That's right. Well, mama gonna get that fur coat after all. That's a good start. Three or four beavers. Yep. Enough to cover parts of her.
Did I grab that other one? There might be one trap laying right over there.